Yeah, good morning, one and all. Now I am going to present a lecture on JDBC. JDBC stands for Java Database Connectivity. Whenever you want your Java program to connect to a database, to interact with a database, you will be needing a Java package, a Java concept called as JDBC. JDBC stands for Java Database Connectivity. Whenever you want your Java program to connect to a database, send some SQL queries to the database and return back those results again to your Java program, for that purpose you will be using JDBC. So JDBC is an API stands for Application Programming Interface. Nothing but it comprises of a set of classes and interfaces which allow your Java program to connect to a database, to interact with the database. So the main advantage of JDBC is it can be used to connect to any database. JDBC provides you database independent API. That is, you can connect to a Oracle database, you can connect to a MySQL database, you can connect to a MS Access database, you can connect to Sybase, you can connect to any database using this JDBC API. So in JDBC API, you have a package called as java.sql package. So java.sql package is the core package which comprises of a set of interfaces that specify the JDBC API. So now we'll be using this, or we'll be studying this java.sql package. Java.sql package is used to connect your Java program with any database. So these are the main steps that allows your Java program to connect to a database or interact with a database. So using JDBC, you can write the code that connects to one or more data servers, one or more databases. Once you are connected to database, next you can send SQL queries to the database. So after sending the SQL, after sending some SQL statements to the database retrieves some results. That results can be stored in an object called as result set. Next, finally, similarly, you can use JDBC to obtain metadata from a data server. If you want to know some information regarding the data server, like what is the version of the database, what is the name of the database, data types is supported by the database, everything, that metadata can be retrieved by using the JDBC. So these are the some of the things that you can do using JDBC. You can connect to database, execute the SQL queries, and retrieve the results back. So before moving on to the practical concepts, first we have to know the JDBC architecture. As given in the right hand side of the diagram, using JDBC architecture, you can connect your Java application to a database. At the bottom, you are having the database. At the top, you are having the Java application or Java program. In between, you are having the JDBC architecture. So JDBC architecture, so in order for your Java application to connect to a database, you will be needing the JDBC API. So using JDBC API or Java application, the database can be connected with each other. So in JDBC API, there is a core component called as a driver. Driver is a software that allows your Java application to load database specific drivers and connect to the database. So whenever you want to connect your Java application to database, always you'll be needing a driver. So all the drivers are managed by a driver manager. For example, if you want to connect to Oracle database, Oracle has one driver. If you want to connect to MySQL database, it will have another driver. Those are called as vendor specific drivers. Every database vendor, while releasing their version, they will release the appropriate JDBC driver. So using that driver only, all those are vendor specific, database specific drivers. The vendors will provide the implementations of those JDBC drivers. So mainly JDBC comprises of JDBC architecture kinds of two parts, JDBC API and the JDBC driver manager. JDBC API is provided by your Java programming language. The driver manager implementations are provided by corresponding database vendors like MySQL vendor, Oracle vendor, or MS Access vendor like that. So these are the more main four steps that we'll be reading throughout this JDBC. Whenever you want to establish a connection between your Java program and the database, these are the four important steps. First important step is, obviously, whenever you want to interact with anyone, first you need to connect to a database. So first step is connection. Second step is, once the connection is established, you can send SQL queries to the database. You can send SQL queries to the database. So once SQL queries are sent from your Java application to the database processes those results, and the processed results can be sent back to your Java application. So third step is process results. Finally, close the connection. This is similar to an idea, analogy between when two persons want to communicate. First, what they do means, first, they need to establish a connection. They need to connect. For example, if you want to make a telephonic conversation, first, they need to dial their number and press on call button. Once the other person leaves, a connection will be established. Then they will talk. They will interchange some statements. They will interchange some statements using their personal language. That is nothing but passing the queries. So once the statements are exchanged, similarly, they can process the results. Whatever interactions happen between those can be together called as passing the queries and processing the results. Finally, they will close the connection. This is given in the diagram. See, same. Whenever your Java applications need to interact with any database, for example, in this case, two databases, consider one is Oracle, another is MySQL. Whenever your Java application need to communicate with database, they need JDBC API. JDBC API provides a set of classes and interfaces that allow your Java applications to connect to the database. So this JDBC API is provided by Java programming language, and the Java specific calls need to be converted into a database specific calls that will be done by the JDBC driver manager. The JDBC driver manager is responsible for loading an appropriate database driver or appropriate vendor specific driver and directing the Java programming calls into a form understandable to the underlying database specific calls. So that is the main use of a JDBC driver manager. See, for example, your Java application, what it comprises of Java language statements. But whereas DBMS, it comprises of some queries. In general, the DBMS are written using the native language, native code, that is C language. So Java applications comprise of Java calls. This DBMS consists of native C calls. So how will be the Java calls will be translated into a form to be understandable to the DBMS means it is a job performed by the JDBC driver. JDBC driver, it translates a Java language statements into a form understandable to the native DBMS calls. So every database will have their specific driver. So which database to connect, which driver to load is loaded by driver manager. Name itself indicates it is the driver manager manages all the JDBC drivers. Which database specific driver to load and connection establishment is done by the driver manager. Once connection is established, the Java calls need to be translated into a form understandable to the DBMS specific native calls, database specific native API calls, that is C calls, that is done by JDBC driver. So this is an explanation that I already gave. So now we'll go step by step. Already I have told you there are four important steps. So now we'll go step by step. So first step is you need to connect to a database. So whenever you want to connect to a database, So these are the two steps involved. First one is register the driver or load a driver. For example, if I want to connect to a Oracle database, you need to load the driver. If you want to connect to a Sybase or you want to connect to MySQL database, you need to loading of the driver. This driver, see, driver is there. Driver is very, very important. You need to load the corresponding driver. Actually, there exists four types of drivers in Java, we will say. You need to load an appropriate driver or register the driver. Using driver only, your Java program can connect to a database. Your database specific calls, your Java programming calls are converted into data space specific calls by the driver. There are four types of JDBC drivers. Using any of the driver, you need to load a driver. So once the driver is ready, you can connect to the database. So that is regarding the connection. In connection, you need to have two things: register the driver, next connect to the database. Once you are connected to the database, you can pass SQL queries. Once SQL queries are passed to the database, database processes SQL queries, returns back the results to your Java application. Once Java application displays those results, finally you can close the connection. These are the four important steps: connect, query, process results, and close. So as I already told you, whenever your JDBC calls need to be converted into database specific calls, you'll be needing a driver. A driver is a specialized software that translates your JDBC calls into database specific native calls. In general, the JDBC calls written using Java programming language, most of the database are written by using the native C language. So again, in the diagram given, for example, consider there is a Java application. Your Java application, in order to connect with a database, will be needing the JDBC API followed by the JDBC driver. Each JDBC driver is vendor specific. For example, Oracle provides. Vendor is nothing but the person who develops the database, who develops and releases it into the market. So for example, Oracle provider will release his corresponding JDBC driver, DB2. Every database will have an underlying JDBC driver. This JDBC API is database independent specification. It can be used to interact with any database. By simply changing the JDBC driver, underlying database driver, you can connect to any database. For example, if I want to connect to Oracle, use Oracle JDBC driver. If I want to connect to DB2, DB2 specific driver. But the same JDBC API can be used to interact or communicate with any database. So what is a JDBC driver? Means a JDBC API defines a set of interfaces mainly defined in java.sql package. It allows you to run the queries, process the results. So a database vendor or third-party developer writes a JDBC driver. Database vendor like Oracle or MySQL, they'll write a JDBC driver, which is nothing but a set of classes that implements the interfaces for particular database system. See, for example, I want to convert the Java calls into a format understandable to the Oracle database, then I need Oracle driver. Oracle provides a corresponding application calls, which converts the Java calls into Oracle calls. So as I already told you, there are four types of JDBC drivers. First type is called as, you have to remember these names. He will ask in the quiz, what is the type 1 driver? There are how many types of JDBC drivers are there? There are four types of JDBC drivers. First one is type 1 driver. Type 1 driver, its name is JDBC ODBC bridge driver. JDBC ODBC bridge driver. See, drivers acts as an interface between your JDBC API and the corresponding database. So JDBC ODBC bridge driver, what it does means, ODBC stands for Open Database Connectivity. Before JDBC, there used to be a concept called as ODBC, Open Database Connectivity. Using that ODBC concept, you can connect your database to any programming language, hence the name Open Database Connectivity. So this JDBC makes use of that ODBC concept, JDBC ODBC bridge driver. So the JDBC calls will be converted into the underlying database by the JDBC ODBC bridge driver. Type 1 driver uses a bridge technology to connect a Java client to a ODBC database system. It can be used to connect to any database. That's the name, Open Database Connectivity. So in general, that ODBC bridge driver was used in C programming language. It was written in C programming language, which is used to connect to any database. Open database means it can be used to connect to any database. So this JDBC ODBC driver makes use of that ODBC connectivity to connect with the any database, as given in the right hand side diagram. That is the architecture. The JDBC API will be converted into JDBC via the JDBC ODBC bridge. It will be converted into underlying database calls. So the type is the JDBC ODBC driver. So it must have ODBC installed on the computer. There will be ODBC drivers. So in order to use this bridge driver, you need the ODBC to be installed on the computer. Similarly, you must have ODBC driver for specific database installed on the computer. For example, if you want to connect to Oracle, you must have the Oracle ODBC, MySQL ODBC. So installation of this database vendor specific driver need to be done. The main disadvantage here is the type 1 driver is very slow. Way it is very slow means the Java calls will be converted into open data bus calls, then it will be converted into database specific calls. Since there are more number of translations between your Java application and the database, this driver is slow way, because first the Java application calls are converted into ODBC calls, then from the ODBC calls to database specific calls. Since there are more number of translations, this driver is very slow. From JDK 1.8 onwards, JDBC type 1 driver has been stopped supporting. So you have to use type 4 driver. If you use Oracle supports type 1, type 2, and type 4 drivers. But from JDK 1.8, type 1 driver has been stopped supporting by Java. So you have to use type 2 or type 4 if you use Oracle database. So coming to type 2 driver name is native API JDBC driver. Native API partly Java driver. For this, on the client machine, you need to have the native API libraries installed on the client machine. That is the disadvantage. Native API means, for example, database specific APIs are called as native APIs. For this driver to work, the native APIs need to be installed on the client machine. So in the client machine, your Java application calls are converted into native API specific calls by the native API partly Java libraries. An example for the type 2 driver is Oracle Call Interface, OCA driver. The example for type 1 driver is Sun's JDBC ODBC driver. Type 1 example is Sun's JDBC ODBC driver. Type 2 driver example is Oracle Call Interface, OCA driver. As this is vendor specific, these are vendor specific libraries. Native API means vendor specific database specific libraries. So these will be provided for, these native libraries exist for every database. So these native libraries needs to be installed on every client machine. Then your Java calls will be converted into underlying database calls by this native API drivers. So native database libraries needs to be installed on the client machine. So these native libraries are responsible for converting your Java database calls into database specific calls. So these are the characteristics of JDBC 2 driver. So the main disadvantage is native libraries needs to be installed on client machine. The advantage is accessing of the database is faster when compared to type 1 driver. Only the disadvantage is native libraries need to be installed on the client machine. So if you want to interact with multiple databases, you need to install multiple native libraries. Native libraries are somewhat costly. So this is the disadvantage of type 2. Coming to type 3. Type 3 driver is also called as JDBC NACT drivers or JDBC, as you can observe, JDBC NACT drivers or Java client to server driver, middleware server driver. As you observe, in between your Java application or your client and in between the database server, you are having a middleware server. So your database specific calls will be converted into network specific calls or database specific calls via a middleware server. Hence the name Java client to server driver. So it translates the JDBC calls into database server independent and middleware server specific net protocol. So this middleware server is database independent. So this type 3 driver translates JDBC calls into database server independent and middleware specific network calls. Hence the name JDBC net drivers. Then it is the responsibility of the middleware server or network server to translate those Java calls into underlying specific calls. Hence the name JDBC net drivers. So the main advantage is these are 100% pure Java drivers. No need of any native libraries to be installed. So this middleware server is database independent server. So your Java calls will be converted into database independent calls by this JDBC type 3 driver, JDBC network drivers, or pure Java client to middleware server driver. So it does not require any client libraries to be installed. So it is faster. So it is 100% pure Java driver. So the only the disadvantage is, again here, the Java calls are not directly converted into database specific calls. In between, the database calls are converted into a database independent network calls. So it is somewhat slower compared to type 2 and type 4. This type 3 driver is not supported by Oracle. Type 3 driver doesn't support or isn't being implemented by Oracle. Oracle supports only type 1, type 2, and type 4. Coming to type 4 driver. The type 4 driver is called as Java to database protocol driver or native protocol all Java drivers. So in this, the Java calls are directly converted into database server or database specific calls by the type 4 driver. This is the fastest among all the four drivers available. So I'll be using in my programs the type 4 driver. Type 4 driver is native protocol all Java drivers are 100% pure Java drivers. So in this type 4 driver directly converts your Java database calls into database specific calls via a, in general, the database server can be connected via a network. So the type 4 drivers are written entirely in Java. So this type 4 driver, they understand database specific network protocols, and they can access the database directly without any additional software. Without any additional software, they convert the Java calls into database specific calls. So the main advantage is they are 100% Java driver, no native methods, and these are the fastest among the four drivers available. So these are the four types of JDBC driver. Type one is JDBC ODBC bridge driver. Example is Sun's JDBC ODBC driver. Type two is native API, partly Java driver. Example is Oracle call interface. Type three is Java, pure Java to middleware server driver or Java network driver. Oracle doesn't support the type 3 driver. Type 4 driver is native protocol to Java to database protocol or native protocol all Java drivers. These are 100% pure Java drivers implemented using Java programming language. So I have to remember the driver names, and there are four database drivers. So now the driver is ready. So now the driver is ready. Driver is ready means once you have registered the driver using any of the type 4 drivers. In general, most of the databases, they will be using type 4 driver. Most of the Java applications, they use type 4 driver to connect to a database. Why? Because type 4 is very, very fast. Type 4 is pure Java driver. They directly convert the type 4 driver. They can understand the Java calls into, and they can convert the Java database calls, Java programming calls into database specific calls. Those type 4 driver, they knows how to connect with the database specific network calls. So once we have registered the driver, next we can connect to a database. See, in order to connect to a database, you'll be mainly needing two things: JDBC API and a driver. Once these two are ready, you can connect to a database, issue the SQL queries, and retrieve the results. See, as given in the diagram, using driver manager, what you can do means driver manager, it loads any of the JDBC driver. So once the driver manager is ready, you can establish a connection with the database. Once connection is established, using that connection object, you can issue a n number of SQL queries via the statement object. The statement object via the JDBC driver helps you to connect with the database. This is the conceptual components of the JDBC. Driver manager, it is used to register a database specific driver. It is used to register a JDBC driver. Once the driver is ready, you can establish a connection with the database. Once connection is established, you can issue SQL statements via the statement interface. The Java language statements are converted into database language calls by the JDBC driver. Here you can have type 1, type 2, type 3, or type 4. And it may return a result set. So from the database, if you issue some SQL statements, they will return some results that can be stored in result set object. All these are the interfaces available in java.sql package. Driver manager is a class available in java.sql package. Connection, statement, and result set are available as interfaces. So this is an explanation. Driver manager, it is used to load database specific drivers and manages connections. Driver translates JDBC specific calls into database specific calls. Connection, the connection maintains a session. So whenever you want to connect to a database, you need to establish a connection. Until that connection is terminated, you can issue any number of SQL statements. So these are the steps, same steps connected. So these steps I'll be using while writing a Java program. Import the necessary classes. That is, you have to import java.sql package. Next, load the JDBC driver, type 1, type 2, or type 4 if you use Oracle database. Next, identify the data source. That is, to which database you want to connect, MySQL or Oracle or Sybase or MS Access, like that. Once you have chosen a data source, since the corresponding driver available, you can connect to the database. Once connection is established, you can issue SQL statements and execute the query using statement object. And obviously, you can retrieve the results. So step one, we have registered the driver. Next to what you can do means you can establish a connection. To establish a connection, you have to use a URL. You will be using this URL. The URL is JDBC column subprotocol. In general, for Oracle database, it is Oracle column. This is called as database formulating URL. Whenever you want to connect to a database, you have to use this URL. Using this URL, you can connect to a database. Once you have chosen a database, you can connect via your Java application to the database using this JDBC URL. This is called as JDBC formulating URL. JDBC column, Oracle column, driver. For example, for type 4, it is thin column at the rate of database URL. This is the syntax. So for type 4 driver, it is JDBC column, Oracle column, thin. Type 4 driver name is thin column at the rate site on which host the database is there. on which server the database installed. At the rate, for example, database available in local system, you can give localhost column, port number on which database is available, port number, column, database name. This port number and database name could be found in a file called as tnsnames.vara. In the tnsnames.vara file, you can find the name of this port number, JDBC column, Oracle column, thin column at the rate of site, the URL or local host where your database is available, port number on which your Oracle can listen to JDBC calls, and the database specific name. This port number and database specific name could be found in a file called as tnsnames.ora. Once install Oracle, you can view those things in that file. So JDBC column, Oracle column, thin column at the rate of localhost in case database is available in your same system where your server is there. If it is in another database, is in another system, you can give this where the database available, IP of the server, database server. So how to find the service name and the port number? So after localhost, you are having port number and service name. That can be found in a file called as tnsnames.vara. In tnsnames.vara, while executing the program, I will show you that file, tnsnames.vara. In that file, you can find the port number and service name. So these are the contents of the file. So in general, the port number will be 1521 and service name will be ORCL. See, I will show now only. See, once you install the Oracle, see, actually, before reading this JDBC, you have to look at the Oracle concepts or the database and SQL concepts. There is a separate video lesson given by Srinu sir. First, you go through that video lesson. If you have an overview of databases and SQL, you can directly view this lecture. Otherwise, first, go through that lecture, then come to this lecture. See, once you install Oracle, for example, in my system, I have installed Oracle in C drive. In this Oracle, go to admin. Go to Oracle, go to Oracle product, 11.2.2 server. In this, you'll be having a folder called as network. In that admin, in this, you'll be having this tnsnames.ora. This is the path. In my case, it is available in C drive, Oracle XE, app, Oracle product 11.2.2 server network admin. In that, you will be having tnsnames.ora file. I'll be opening the tnsnames.ora file in the Oracle. Here you can observe the port number. See, observe XE equal to description. In this, you'll be having this port number. This is your port number. And service identification name, that is available in service name, that equal to XA. So tnsnames.ora file contains the description of the Oracle service name. In this case, my service name is XE, capital XE. Later, I will use this service name and port number while formulating the database URL. See, if you don't remember the part, simply go to Oracle XE app, Oracle, simply in search type tnsnames.org, then automatically that file's path will be retrieved. If you remember, it's okay. Otherwise, you can type in the search bar. It will be available in network folder. Remember, it will be available Oracle network folder in network admin. In network admin, tnsnames.org file, you can find the port number. And in this case, the service name is ORCL, but in my system for Oracle 11, it is XE. You can find in that tnsnames.ora file. In tnsnames.ora file, you can find that file. See, for example, I have searched for the tnsnames.ora file. Simply right click, you can go open file location. See, automatically that file will be open. Now you can open it in Notepad where you can observe. If you remember the path, okay. Otherwise, simply in C drive Oracle folder, you type tnsnames.ora Quora file. Directly that file will be opened. There you can find port number and service name. So this is the formatting URL. This is the at the rate localhost column 1521 column XCE in my case. So these are the two steps to connect to a database. Registering of a driver. So to register a driver, this is the syntax. So this syntax I will write while writing a program. Class dot for name of oracle dot jdbc dot driver dot oracle driver. This registers a driver. This is used to register a driver. Second step is connecting to a database. To connect to a database, you have a connection interface. Connection con equal to driver manager dot get connection of URL. Now, just now has seen the database formatting URL, that URL comma user ID and password of your database. User ID and password of your database. In this case, the username and password is system in Tiger. So these are the two steps. Next. Next, once you have registered the driver and you have connected to the database using connection interface, then what you can do means you can execute the queries. By using the statement object, you can execute the queries. So first step is you have to register for the driver. Second step is you have to establish a connection. Once these two steps are over, then only you can go for passing SQL queries to the database and retrieve the results or processing the results. For executing queries and processing results, you are having statement object to pass the queries, and to pass the for processing results, you are having various interfaces like results. So once connection is established, next what you can do means you can query. So to pass SQL queries to the database, you need to create a statement object and pass SQL queries via the statement object. So you will be using an object called a statement object. So you can pass the statement object has three methods to pass the SQL statements. Using the statement object, you can pass three SQL statements. So for select statements, you know, for example, if I write select star from table name, you will be using execute query method. Statement objects execute query is used to pass as select statements. Similarly, you can use execute update for insert, update, delete, or DDL. DDL stands for data definition language statements. Like create or drop, for those you'll be using execute update. You can use execute method for either of the statements. For either execute query or execute update, you can use execute. Execute will return either select statement or it can execute insert, update, delete, or DDL statements. It can be used for either of the statements. So the necessary interface for statement object is java.sql. Statement. Using the statement interface, you can pass SQL statement to the database. There are two more kinds of statements available in java.sql package, prepared statement and callable statement. These are available as another topic. While discussing the topic, I'll discuss. Remember, to pass simple SQL queries, you'll be having the statement object. So this is the syntax to create a statement object. Statement STMT equal to con. With the established connection in the previous step, you'll be using that connection to send SQL statement. So con.create statement will open the stream to send SQL statements. So once the stream is open, you can pass SQL statements using, for example, execute query. Execute query, it is used for select statement. For example, select star from table name. In general, the select statement retrieves the data in form of rows and columns. That rows and columns data can be stored in result set. In case of statement dot execute update will be used for insert, delete, update. They will return an integer value indicating how many rows are affected. Hence, the return type is integer value. Similarly, execute, third kind of statement execute, it returns a Boolean value. Boolean value means true or false. True in case multiple rows and columns are retrieved, false in case of DML statements. like select, like update, insert, or those things. So DDL and DM statements are already covered in the DBMS and SQL concepts. DDL stands for data definition language statements. DML stands for data manipulation language statements. Whenever you try to manipulate any data, you'll be using DML statements. So for a statement dot, for execute query, you'll be using the selector. For DML statements, you'll be using execute update. For insert, delete, update, you'll be using execute update. So next step is process the results. So step three is processing the results. So to process the results, you can process the results. For example, if I'm using select statement is used to retrieve the field names and values from the database. For that, you'll be using the get methods. For example, if I want to retrieve string, you'll be using get string. To retrieve an integer, you'll be using get int. So before processing row by row, for result set, processing the results, we'll be using result set. Result set will be used in case of execute query. For statements execute query, you will be using select statement. That select statement retrieves a logical set of rows and columns. It retrieves a set of rows and columns. The set of rows and columns can be stored in a logical entity called as result set. So before processing the result set, we have to check whether there are any rows available or not. So using the next. First, you have to check whether rows are available or not using next method. Then only I can retrieve the results using getX methods. So without retrieving the results, without checking whether rows are available or not, if you try to retrieve the results, it will throw a checked exception called as SQL exception. See, for example, when I want to process the results, using a select statement, it retrieves the results. I want to store the results using a result set. First, I need to check whether rows are there or not. Then only I need to process them. Then only I need to retrieve them. Without checking whether rows are available or not, if you try to retrieve them, it will throw a SQL exception. So remember, before using the JDBC drivers, you need to set class path. So the class path remember you have to set the class path. Class path indicates where your database specific libraries are installed. I have told you every JDBC driver will be specified by, will be provided by database specific vendor. Then the driver will be implemented by the database. So I have installed Oracle. So the JDBC, ODBC driver or the Oracle driver that understands Java calls is provided by the corresponding class path. So I have to set the class path. This is the program I'll explain. So once you have processed the results, finally, you have to close the all the open streams. When you close all the open streams, then only the memory that is allocated to those objects will be clear. It is always a good programming practice to close the opened objects, to close the open streams. Then only memory deallocation will be done by the Java runtime environment. It is always a good programming practice to close the open streams. So these are the four steps for any program. Remember, these are the four steps: connecting to the database, querying the database, processing the results, and closing the connection. So these can be closed like this: resultset.close, statement.close, finally connection.close. So always it is a good programming practice to close all the open connections so that whichever memory is allocated to those objects or to those interfaces will be clear, and that object can be proclaimed by the Java garbage collector. So it is always better to close all the opened objects or closed streams. So now I'll explain with the help of a program. So before compiling or executing your program, you have to make sure that you'll be setting the class path. So class path is available in Oracle product. 1.2.1 server. The server will be having JDBC folder in the lib. So you have to set class path for, if I use for 11.2.0, it is OJDBC 5. If we have Oracle 10J Express Edition, it is OJDBC 14.jar. See, what is this jar file means? I have told you. The JDBC drivers will be implemented by underlying database vendors. For example, here I am choosing the Oracle as my database. So if, since I choose Oracle as my database, so the JDBC driver for Oracle need to be provided by Oracle. So what this driver does means, this OJDBC 5.jar file takes my Java calls and converts the Java calls into a database understandable calls. In this case, my Oracle database. So this OJDBC 5.jar file, it translates my Java data, it translates my Java calls into database specific calls. So this is the path. I will type in notepad. So this is the path for OJDBC 5.jar. This is the path for 11.2.0. If you use Oracle 10 edition, it will be OJDBC 14.jar, like that. You can search for net for the corresponding specific implementations of the underlying database specific drivers. So this OJDBC 5.jar contains implementations of the Oracle driver. So this Oracle driver translates your Java calls into database specific calls. So first you need to set the class path. You need to set class path to the above file. Already has set the class path. You already know how to set the class path, that I will not repeat. Just you need to go to my computer, I click on it, go to environmental variables. In that you will be having under system variables class path. See, in that I have already set the path. You need to set class path to that variable. I have already set the path. See, C drive Oracle, here is the value. So you have to set class path to OJDBC 5.jar in case of Oracle Express Edition 11.2.0. So remember, always that file will be available server JDBC lib folder. So already have set the class path. Before you start executing your JDBC programs, you need to set the class path to that file. So you have to set the class path to that file. Next, you can write the programs. So now I'll write the programs. So first program, see, for example, see, to write Java programs that connect to a database, we'll be needing JDBC API. The JDBC API is available in java.sql package. So first you have to import that package. So this package is provided by java.sql package. This is JDBC API, which allows you to connect to a database. So I'll write class JDBC demo public static void main string args. See, so first step, what is the first step? So you have to remember those first steps. You have to remember the four steps that allow you to connect to a database. First step is you have to register the driver. For example, to register a Oracle driver, the syntax is class dot for name of, that is already given in slides, Oracle dot JDBC dot driver dot Oracle driver. So I have to remember the syntax. What is the syntax to load Oracle driver? Oracle dot JDBC dot driver dot Oracle driver. So this registers a driver. So after registering the driver, what you need to do? You need to, so JDBC API is there, driver is there. Next, what you can do is you can establish a connection with the driver. So before that, I will just print the message system.out.println. driver loaded. That means my JDBC driver is loaded into the memory. Next, what I need to do means I need to establish a connection with the database. Connection on equal to, this is the syntax already given in slides, driver manager dot get connection of JDBC column, Oracle column, tin column at the rate of, since my database is in the same system, localhost column, port number 1521, column, Oracle service name, that is XE. This is called as database URL. See, driver manager's get connection method accepts three parameters. Database URL, this is the database URL for type 4 driver. I'll be using type 4 driver. Type 4 driver name is thin driver. Where it is called as thin driver means it directly converts your Java calls into database specific calls. The type 4 driver can take your Java database calls. It takes the Java application calls and converts into the database specific network protocol calls. So for example, second and third parameters are name and password for your Oracle database. For my computer, the name of the database is HR and password is Venu. So once you install the Oracle database, whichever username and password you are having, you have to provide those database. See, I'll write. Now I'll write system.out.println connected to database. So now I'll say this program as JDBC demo.java. See, remember, first is you need to have JDBC API to connect to database. Second one is we need to register the driver. This is the syntax to register the driver. Next step is you have to connect to a database. To connect to a database, you are having connection interface. It is initialized with driver manager's get connection method. You already know driver manager. Driver manager is used to establish connect with your database by loading database specific drivers. So this is the formulating URL. See, now I will open my database. For example, this already will be explained by Srinu sir. You go through that material. So to connect to a database, I'll be needing username. As I already told you, the username for my system is HR and password is Venu. It will show connected. This I will connect to a database. So the database, this is the formatting URL, JDBC column, Oracle column, thin column, at the rate of localhost column, port number, column, service name, on which Oracle can listen to your Java calls. This is port number 1521, service name of Oracle for my system is XE. You can check this 1521 and XE in TNS names of Oracle. So now I have saved the file. Now I'll open command prompt. Try to execute it. Java C space. See, actually it is giving unreported exception, class not found exception, unreported exception, SQL exception. Actually, this class dot for name, it tries to load a driver. For example, consider you didn't load the driver, then it throws a checked exception. This is used to connect with a database. For example, consider it didn't install the database. It throws a checked exception. These are the checked exceptions. Checked exceptions are the exceptions which you need to compulsory handle. So simply I'll write throws exception. So you need to put the statements in the try catch block or directly wrote throws exception. So now for simplicity, I'll be writing throws exception. You already know how to handle the exceptions. Wherever there is a possibility of occurrence of error, you can enclose those statements in a try catch block. Otherwise, you can use a throws keyword. Here I am handling the exception using throws. Otherwise, you can put the statements in try catch block. So I'll save it. Remember, class dot furname throws a checked exception called as class not found exception, that is only shown, right? Throws class not found exception, and this database formatting URL get connection method throws SQL exception. So we have to compulsory handle those exceptions. See, now the errors are gone, maybe because I have handled the exception. Now try to execute JDBC demo. See, I have got driver loaded, connected to database. All of you first try this program in your systems. Once you get these two statements, then only try the remaining programs. Why? Because whenever you want to connect to a database, first you need to register the driver or load the driver. Next, establish a connection. Once the connection is established, connection establishment means a session will be created. Until and unless you close that session, you can pass SQL statements. So this is the first program. Now I'll take the same program. So now I'll take the same program. I'll continue with my second program. I'll name it as JDBC demo one. So once I have established connection to the database, next what can I do means, for example, in the Oracle, I will create a table, create. You already know the syntax to create a table. Create table students. For example, I want to show the students' information. Students name, varchar 2 of 20. This all these things that will be given in DBMS material. So I want to create a students with name, it is roll number. For example, roll number, it is of number type. And name, roll number, and I want to store his email ID. Email ID, it is again of type, I will take it as varchar 2. Now I have created a table. I have created a table, with the name students. Now I want to insert, for example, insert into students space values. For example, I will insert some name. For example, my name, Venu, comma, roll number, it is an integer value, 1212, email ID, venu@gmail.com. See, one row created, just I will display in database, select star fm, dnts. See, I have created a table and I have inserted a row. Now I want to display the student database details in my Java program. I want to display the student details in my Java program. So I will minimize this database. So first step again is loading of the driver, connecting the database. Now I want to retrieve or send SQL statements to the database. To send SQL statements to the database, you are having statement interface. Already explained in the slides. Statement st equal to, I need to pass the SQL statements via the created connection. Via the established session, I want to send SQL queries. Once connection is established, you can send any number of SQL queries using the statement object. Statement st equal to con dot create statement. With create statement, what it does means it creates an output stream. Using the output stream, you can pass SQL queries. So for example, I want to retrieve the results. To retrieve the results, which query is there? Already I wrote the query here. To retrieve the results, select query is there. So result set r is equal to statement dot to pass SQL statement. To pass select statement, I have already told you will be using statements execute query method. So statement dot execute query of select star fm. For example, table name is students, students. So this is the query I'm passing from the program. So whenever you want for select statement, you will be using the statements execute query. Execute query returns a set of rows and columns. See, it's for database, it rows, it returns a set of rows and columns. The set of rows and columns could be stored in a logical set with the name result set. So now I need to pass a result set. So to pass the result set, firstly you need to check whether any roles are available or not. Without checking whether roles are available or not, if you try to pass, if you try to retrieve the results, it will throw a checked exception. Already I have told you. So first you have to check whether roles are available in the database or not by using while of rs.nice. Then only you need to process. For example, I will process system.out.print. So to retrieve the data, there is a method called as rs.get. First data type is string. rs.get string of 1 plus slash t. Slash t stands for tab. rs.second is of type integer. To retrieve integer data types are having get int plus slash t. Third one is rs.get string of 3. rs.get string of 3. See, rs.get string of 1 means it retrieves name. rs.get string of 2 retrieves roll number. rs.get string of 3 retrieves email ID. That is, get string of 1 retrieves first column field in the table students. Second column field, it is an integer, so get int. Third is get string. If it is boolean value, you can use get boolean. So like that, it will print all the rows. So I will write system.out.println. So as I already told you, it is always good programming practice to close all the open objects. So use first close the result set, then close the statement, then close the connection. Once the connection is closed, we cannot pass no more SQL queries. It ends the session. So now I will save this file as jdbc-demo1.java. So now I will compile the program. The program is compiled. I execute. It is not displaying. It is not displaying. System.out.println. To database. So wait, is not displaying means for the first time, whenever I open the database after inserting arrow, I need to write con. I need to commit. Then only the results will be shown in my database. Again, I will compile the program. Again, I will execute it. Now see, the results are displayed. venu12212@gmail.com. See, for the first time when you open a database, if you insert freshly, you need to type commit. Otherwise, the rows will not be visible. So whenever you want to retrieve the results, you will be using select statement. So see, four steps: registering of the driver, next connecting to the database, next you can pass the SQL queries, next retrieving the results. After retrieving the results, close the connection. So in case of select statement, you will be using statements execute query, return type is result set. Now I'll tell you directly from your program how you can insert. That is the next program. I'll copy it. I have displayed the results. Now I'll try to insert the details from my program. Same steps, loading of the driver, connecting the database. Next statement, same statement. Now instead of execute query, I have to use execute update. Execute update, what it returns means it returns an integer value. For example, I'll store any integer value n. Execute update is used to pass DML statements to the database, like update, insert, for insert, for update, for drop, all these things we'll be using execute update. For DML and DDL statements, except select, you'll be using execute update for all other statements. They're written an integer value, indicating how many rows are affected after executing that query. Now, for example, I want to insert details into database. Insert into, table name is students. Insert into students, space values. Now I want to insert some values. For example, I want to insert Ramu, comma, roll number 1213, comma, his email ID, tom@gmail.com. So just I am inserting three values into the same students table. Now what you need to do, if insertion is successful, that is it returns a one value, because I am inserting one row. N indicates how many rows are affected because of this query. Because of insert query, only one row is affected. If I use update, multiple rows may be affected. Then n contains that how many rows are affected. So if simply I'll check if n greater than 0, if no rows are affected, n returns 0. If n is greater than 0, simply put system.out.println one row inserted. So now I'll save this program as JDBC demo 2.java. Java C space JDBC demo 2.java. There is no result set, so no need to close it. So I have compiled it. It is saying one row inserted. Now I'll go to the database and I'll check. See? And did all queries, you can use execute update. For remaining all other queries, you can use execute update. So these are the some of the programs. So similarly, you can experiment. If you use update, use execute update, you can experiment with all the queries. Similarly, you can accept the input from the user and you can insert. For example, I want to accept the input from the user. To accept the input from the user, you are having scanner class. So I'll use, for example, import java.util.star. So in java.util.star, you are having scanner class. Scanner s equal to new space scanner of system.in. So for example, I'll ask system.out.println enter your name. See, now instead of passing static values, I'll be passing from the keyboard. So enter your name. I'll be taking the name in string name. String name equal to s dot next. Scanners next method is used to read a string. Now I'll ask enter your roll number. I'll be storing the roll number inside number. So to read an integer, there is a method called as nextInt. Similarly, I'll ask for his email ID. Enter your email ID. S dot email ID is again S dot next. I'll be storing it in email. So now I need to use these values that are passed via the keyboard by the user to insert into the database. So now I'll be using those values to insert the details into the database. So insert into students space values Now, instead of Ramu, that value must come from the program. For that, you need to concatenate. Simply, you need to concatenate. For concatenation, you will be using, you know, Java, double quotation plus plus double quotation. Simply, you are concatenating the value entered by the user from the keyboard. Now, we need to concatenate number plus roll number is available in NVO plus double quotation. Here, no need of single quotation, maybe because number is an integer. See, number is an integer. No need to concatenate. In NVO, s.next reads an integer. No need of single quotation. Again, single quotation, double quotation, plus. Double quotation, single quotation. So this thing email. So now I will save. Now I will save the program. Same program. Now instead of passing static values, I'm passing the values from the keyboard, and these values will be inserted into the database. Again, I will compile the program. Again, I will execute. See, it is asking enter your name. I'll give some ABC. It is asking for roll number. I'll give 1201. It is asking email ID. I'll be giving abc@gmail.com. It is saying one row inserted. Now I can go for the database and check. Select star from students. See, I have inserted abc1201abc@gmail.com. It is usable in database. So like that, you can insert by accepting input from the keyboard. Similarly, the same program can be extended. The same program can be made as a Java Swing application or Java AWT application, where you can use graphical interfaces, and using that graphical interfaces, whichever input the user gives, that can be inserted into the database. So in this way, you can use Java programs to connect to the database. Simply, you need to remember those four steps. Registering of the driver, establishing connection with the database, passing SQL queries to the database, retrieving the results. So these are the steps you need to follow. With this, the introduction class is over. Thank you.